I will tell of the Battle of Hastings, as happened in days long gone by, when Duke William became King of England, and Harold got shot in the eye. It were this way. One day, in October, the Duke, who were always a tough, and having no battles on at moment, had given his lads the day off. Well, they'd all taken boats and gone fishing, when someone, in Conqueror's ear, said, "Let's go and put Breeze up Saxons." Bill said, "By gum, that's an idea." So turning around to his soldiers, he lifted his big Norman voice. He said, "Hands up, who's coming to England?" That was swank, because they hadn't no choice. Well, they started away about tea time. The sea was so calm and so still. And at 9:45 the next morning, they arrived at a place called Bexhill. King Harold, he came up when they landed, his face full of venom and hate. And he said, "If you've come for regatta, you've got here just 6 weeks too late." Well, at this, William rose, cool but haughty, and said, "Let's have none of your cheek. You'd best have your throne reupholstered. I'll be wanting to use it next week." Well, when Harold heard this here defiance, with rage he turned purple and blue, and he shouted some rude words in Saxon, to which William answered, "And you." 'Twere a beautiful day for a battle. Normans set off with a will, and when both sides were duly assembled, they tossed for the top of the hill. King Harold, he won the advantage. On the hilltop, he took up his stand, with his knaves and his cads all around him. On his horse, with his hawk in his hand. That was pathetic. Shall we try it again? On his horse, with his hawk in his hand. Thank you, Local 27. That was very nice. Well, Normans had knelt in their favour. Their chance of a victory seemed small, for the slope of the field were against them and the wind in their faces and all. Kickoff was sharp at 2:30. And as soon as the whistle had went, both sides started banging each other till swineherds could hear them in Kent. Well, Saxons had best line of forwards, well armed with both buckler and sword. But Normans had best combination, so when half time came, neither had scored. So the Duke called together his cohorts, "Psst, hey, come here," and said, "Let's pretend that we're beat. When we get Saxons down on level, we'll cut off their means of retreat." So they ran, and Saxons ran after, just exactly as William had planned, leaving Harold alone on the hilltop, on his horse, with his hawk in his hand. Yes, well, when William, he saw what had happened, a bow and an arrow he drew. He went right up to Harold and shot him. He were offside, but what could they do? Well, the Normans turned round in a fury and give back both parry and thrust till fight were all over bar shouting and you couldn't see Saxons for dust. And after battle were over, they found Harold so stately and grand, sitting there with an eye full of arrow, on his horse, with his hawk in his hand.